What's up, Codetutorials? In today's video, we'll be diving into a powerful platform that's been gaining traction as a compelling alternative to Heroku for deploying Node.js applications, Render. Render offers a seamless experience for developers with a user-friendly interface and robust features that make deploying applications a breeze. Before we embark on our journey with Render, let's ensure we're all on the same page. If you haven't done so already, head over to Render's website, which you can find at render.com. There, you will be greeted by a clean and inviting homepage that showcases what this platform has to offer. To get started, you will need to create a Render account. Simply click on the Sign Up button and you will be guided through a straightforward registration process. Provide your email address, set a strong password, and hit that Sign Up button. Once you have done that, Render may send a verification link to your email. Make sure to check your inbox and click on the link to activate your account. Once you're logged in, you should be greeted by Render's intuitive dashboard with all the deployment options presented on the screen. But before we play around with the dashboard, let's quickly go ahead and set up a simple Node.js Express app and push it to GitHub, as we will be needing it later. We have created a really simple Express app on our computer that has only one endpoint that just says, "Hello World." We'll be pushing this into the GitHub repository to deploy it on Render. Render provides a seamless integration with version control platforms, making it really easy to manage changes made to your projects. So let's head over to github.com and create a new repository. We will be using this repository as a demo to deploy it on Render. For the sake of simplicity, we're naming this repository as Simple Express App. Let's also set the description of the project as we wish. We can use the default values for the rest of the fields for this example. Now that our GitHub repository is created, let's push the code of our existing Express app from our local computer to this repository. You may follow the steps given here, or just copy the entire code and paste it in the terminal. Once that's done, all the changes should be reflected on your GitHub repo. Alright, now let's get back to Render. In the Render dashboard, click on New and select New Web Service. If you are trying to host a static site, you could select the Static Site option from the list. Render provides a variety of options for different tech stacks, but today we are focusing on Node.js deployment, which is why we are selecting Web Service. Now this is the part where we are going to connect our GitHub repository with Render for deploying our application. Select Build and Deploy from a Git repository and click on Continue. If you know what you are doing, you could also use the advanced options for more control over the configurations that you make. Click on Next and then click on Connect GitHub. You will have to authorize Render to access your account. Click on Authorize Render and then select All Repositories and install Render to give access to all of your repositories to Render. At this point, if you have done everything as expected, you should be able to see all of your repositories listed on the screen. Choose the repository that you want to deploy and click on Connect. You will be asked to enter some basic details of your project for this to work. Choose an appropriate name for your project. Keep the name of your project short if you don't want the URL of your app to be too long. Now, select a region that's closest to you or your audience. Select the branch that you want to be deployed on Render. For the most part, leave it to main. If your project has a custom root directory, specify it here. Otherwise, you can leave it as it is. For the build command, we will set it to npm install, as we want all the dependencies to be installed before starting our server. And finally, for the start command, set it to npm start if you have a start command, or node server.js as shown here. For this example, we'll be using the free instance. If you are about to host a large application and scale it up, choose an instance that best fits your needs. Finally, click on Create Web Service. Render will take over and build your project now. Cross your fingers and just hope that you have done everything as expected and your website should be live in a few moments. If there are no errors, you will be greeted with "Your service is live" in the console.
Click on the link that's provided and congratulations, your website is live. And there you have it, a comprehensive guide to deploying Node.js applications on Render. Its intuitive interface, seamless deployment process, and robust management tools make it a compelling alternative to Heroku. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and give it a thumbs up. Share your thoughts and experiences with Render in the comments below. Until next time, happy coding.